preacher. He's not a perfect pastor. And so if you think of anything that's funny, I just feel free to share that as well. So no further ado, let's see Abby's slideshow.
need you to soften my heart and break me apart. I need you to open my eyes and see that you're shaping my life. And all I am, I surrender. Give me faith, trust what you say, that you're good and your love is great. I'm broken inside, I give you my life. I need you to soften.
Wonderful job, Abby. Thank you so much. It took a little time? No. Are we ready to go? All right. I was told I had to stall. Good. We're finished. So go for it.
I appreciate Steve and Ange and the whole family for that matter because they're so darn lovable. Open to communicating with other people, such a joy in service, and so friendly in their relating to others. We just love you, Steve and Ange, and we thank you for 20 years of wonderful service.
Steve, really appreciate your heart for the ministry, and not only your heart, but your talent. I've appreciated serving with you. Fun to work with, talented, and just appreciate your heart. Thank you.
I appreciate Ange for her encouragement because if through her cards and anytime I talk to her, she just has a word of encouragement for me, and I just always really appreciate that about Ange. Pastor Steve, the event that kind of pops out in my mind is the time when you came to our house to pray over Lauren. She's still in her crib, and I think you knew we were nervous. First-time parents, and she had an upcoming surgery, and we just appreciated you taking time out of your busy schedule to come to our house to pray over Lauren and just the support that you gave us through her surgeries and through that time with her. We just appreciate that so much.
Pastor Steve, I've always thought that you're more than a preacher. And that's what I've always loved about you. And it doesn't matter where we are in the community, I see you. And I see you coming alongside the broken. And just every time we've ever needed you, you've been there. So that's what I appreciate about you. And Ange, just your friendly, smiling face all the time and putting up with Steve is what we appreciate you for. That's it.
Pastor Steve and Ange, we would just like to say thank you for your ministry here. We thank you for your heart and your compassion for the people of our community. And we thank you for the presence that you have in our greater community. Everyone knows Unity Church, and they relate to you, Pastor Steve and Ange. And we just thank you for that good presence in our whole entire greater community. I'm also thankful for your grace to people and that you accept people where they're at, and that it's not an earned grace, but it's a gift from Jesus. And we appreciate that aspect of your ministry, and we just appreciate your smiling faces and your willingness to work, and especially the things that you do behind the scenes are wonderful, and we really appreciate that. I wanted to say thank you.
Yeah, I was going to add to that too. Angie, you were such a hard worker, and we just thank you so much for your giving and giving and giving spirit. And you truly have a servant's heart. And I see at the hospital too what a compassionate woman you are, and we're very fortunate to have you. And for the record, you would have been an excellent nurse as well.
We wish, and we wish for you and pray for you another 20. When I think of servant leaders, I think of you, Steve. I have not seen anybody, maybe outside of Jesus himself, serve the body of believers the way you have. Thank you for your example, my friend.
And I just want to pray a blessing. So, Father, we thank you for Steve and Ange and for their years of service. And we, as John said, we pray for 20 more, but we pray for increased strength and anointing, fresh anointing, fresh strength, fresh wisdom, and
that well, Pastor Steve married us, and it's nice to have a couple like that in church who, well, we have over for supper now, and have another couple to talk to and just stuff.
And they're very wise with each other, and you can tell they have so much love for each other, so it's kind of good to look up to them. And what I appreciate about them is that they just love everybody holistically. No matter what baggage you come with, they take it all in, and they help you through it, or they encourage you with anything you do. And that's why we love them and appreciate them.
Well, hi, Steve and Ange. I'm so glad that you are here with us in this church. You bring inspiring messages, and I appreciate so much what you do to prepare us for worship through music, your piano playing. It really blesses us as a church, but I just thank you, too, for all you do in the community. Thank you, Ange, this morning for the delicious oatmeal. And the many ways that behind the scenes you are doing your work. And I love your family. I love your children. And I see how God has used you in teaching the children the ways of the Lord. And thank you for your example. Thank you for your faithfulness to us. And we just so much appreciate all that you do.
So I want to thank you, Pastor Steve and Ange, for making me feel so welcome here at Unity, and hope to see you more in the future.
Pastor Steve and Angie and family from the Hans, we want to really thank you for welcoming us to this community, especially just being awesome neighbors. And we appreciate your willing to help us in any different way as we've moved in and transitioned to this community. I also want to give a special thanks for allowing the W flag to be flown here at church. I think that's pretty awesome. So thanks from the Hans, and we appreciate you guys greatly.
Hey, Steve, this is Jeff Schmitz. Thank you for everything you've done for the community. Congratulations on 20 years at Prinsburg at Unity. Thanks for being the man I entrusted to help me and my wife get married, and just thanks for all the leadership you've provided over the years. God bless, and congratulations.
What we appreciate about Pastor Steve and Ange, I think I can speak for Dave. He wasn't able to be here today, but I think I can speak for both of us when we say that you're always there when we need you. We were just starting out our family when you guys moved here. We were married the same year that you guys moved into town here, so when I look back at all the important things in our lives, you guys have been there. Some that stick out for me are the day that we had Ella, and when I came to in the ICU, Pastor Steve, you were there, and just the comfort that I felt that you were there in our time of need, and for Dave and the rest of our family. And Ange, I remember having our first baby, Aiden, and he was in the intensive care nursery, and you brought a meal up to the hospital for us. And I just remember thinking how good that meal was when we were so sick of hospital food. Just your thoughts and just your ability to know when to be there and how to be there. And we love you guys. So thank you for everything you do.
I have a little appreciation to Pastor Steve and Angie for their anniversary. And I'm saying happy anniversary to them, and I'm thanking to them that they were there for me anytime I want, and especially for Maya's birthday. And they supported me for anything, and they helped me for rental a couple times according to together in the church. And I need to appreciate Angie that she support my father while she working in Rice. And that's all I want to say. Thank you and a happy anniversary.
Zwart, we love the way that you lead in this community and do life and love people and are a great light.
Angelina really likes it when you say wake up in church.
Yep.
We love you, Pastor Steve and Ange. We appreciate how you always welcome us with open arms, and we can walk in late and we don't even get a weird look from you. Thank you.
Pastor Steve and Angie and family, we're asked to do this, so it kind of feels like it puts us on the spot, but it's pretty easy for me to think of one thing, and that is you always are happy. You're happy. Not only are you our spiritual leader, Pastor Steve, but you love people, and you are content with it, and you truly show joy in the Lord. And that's an example for me. I also see you across the street from where I live and how you raise your children, and it's surely passing on to them, too. Your children are wonderful role models of who you are and what you're doing in this community. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Hey, congratulations, Pastor Steve and Angela, from over here in the Gambia on 20 years of ministry in Brinsbury.
Yep, we thank you and appreciate being partners together with you guys there.
And we speak God's blessings in Jesus' name over your continued ministry. Bye.
Bye. Bye.
I like Pastor Steve and Pastor Steve are funny.
They're funny?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. What would you
and
like?
And they teach us about the gospel.
About the gospel?
I like Pastor Steve because he taught me about the gospel and some things I didn't know, and also he baptized me.
Steve and Ange, I feel like we've walked a long time together. Been grateful for the relationship with you in this church, both as leaders, humble servant leaders, willing to be challenged for growth and also challenging me and Kirk for growth. I think especially of the early years when we were able to be part of a small group together, and how you guys kind of risked vulnerability with a small group of us, and we really felt privileged to be a part of that circle. With you. Of course, the time that you came and visit us in Haiti, that was really sweet fellowship. Feeling like you could understand a piece of our lives there was really meaningful to us. And since our return from Haiti, just having fellowship with you, the little gifts, the little touches, Ange, that you have given in our lives for remembering birthdays and knowing things that we really would like, that's been really a neat part of having a relationship with you, Ange. And so we're just grateful for how the two of you lead as a couple, as a family. Been grateful to be able to have your kids in our lives too.
We appreciate what God-fearing leaders you guys have been in this community and in all of our lives. I can't count the times that you've just been there with your presence, your service. You guys are truly amazing, and this place would not be what it is without you. I appreciate all of the children that you've raised. Getting to be a part of their lives has been absolutely amazing. And every Sunday when I can't find my own kids, I know where they are. Usually up on Allie's lap playing piano or playing drums. You guys are just amazing, and you are a blessing, and we love you.
Hi, Stephen, Ange, and Zwart family. Sending our love from Michigan. One of the many, many things we so appreciate about you is your immense love for people, your compassion, your gifts of hospitality, and we've seen those so often and experienced those so much ourselves.
Congratulations on 20 years of ministry, faithfully preaching the word and living the gospel in your family and in your lives. Blessings to you all.
See you later.
Teaches the gospel, even watches sports.
He plays piano.
He preaches. He takes naps most of his days.
Talk.
Play on a computer.
Take care of my brother.
He naps and preaches.
Join the church.
He gets to teach the Bible and we get to learn about God.
Oh, preaches.
Works with my mom.
He talks about God and what he thinks you should do, and that's it.
And thank you for Becky Berry for pulling those together. And there were other people involved in pulling it together as well. So we're going to have a little bit of an open mic time. And I'm sure you're all ready and primed with things to say. So if I could get a couple of runners to run mics around. Do I have any volunteers? Not all at once. There we go. Travis and... Go for it, Kevin. No, aren't you lined up here? No, you're the mic holder now. This was just a trick. When they wave their hand, then that's a signal.
To Pastor Steve and Angie. I thought I could be real creative and do a poem. Well, I got about three lines. I said, we've had good times and bad, happy and sad, rejoicing and anointing, and then my creative flow quit. But I just want to say that we've been blessed. You helped lead Cassie to this congregation and helped lead her to the Lord, and by that you got us here, and how we've enjoyed the many hours of fellowship and blessings that you've given us. You've been a blessing to our family. We rejoice that you've married all our children. You've celebrated the lives of all our grandbabies. You've been with us through many sad moments and sending our loved ones to heaven, and we just thank you for that. I never will be able to say thank you enough, and I want to say a special thank you to Angie, too. She has taught me a personal lesson, how that it's all right to have help and accept it and ask for it. And I want to thank that entire family, because I know many times you're probably sitting down to a supper or a family gathering and one of us have called, and Pastor Steve, you've run to be with us even if it wasn't one of your flock, and we just want to thank you all. And mostly I want to thank God that we've all been able to share these 20 years with you. Thank you.
I'm going to echo that, everything that my mother said, and I have been blessed immeasurably by Pastor Steve and Ange and that whole family. You have done a great job raising your kids. Thank you for being here. And Steve, I just, you've helped me through many things in life, and I just am so blessed to have known you and to continue to know you and get your great big hugs. Thank you so much.
I'll give one quick story about Heather and I's wedding day. And even before the wedding day, our premarital counseling was on a golf course in Renville. So it only took, 18 holes wasn't quite enough for our counseling. But yeah, we would have loved to have shared a picture with us and Pastor Steve on our wedding day, but he was not there. So it was there the day before. We went through the walkthrough, but he was in the emergency room, and so thank goodness that he was prepared with his notes that Pastor Jeff was able to come in and marry us. But no, thank you for everything, and I think somebody said in the video, you know, when we have the newborn, Ange would bring over food, and there was nothing better in the freezer than pulling out a pre-made meal by Ange. So thank you to both you and your family.
Since I drove 3 hours, do I get two short stories? All right. So the first, one of the best stories I've got, or one of my favorites, is fairly recent. We were at a dinner. By the way, I've got lots of stories I could share, but only a few that I dare share here. So is that okay, Steve? We had a dinner event, actually a celebration for Mike's graduation, and we were gathered around tables eating, and there's a lot of people there, and sometimes political discussions come up, and that's always a little bit dangerous. And so this was one of those times. And the discussion came up about helping the poor, caring for the poor. And there was this rather stuffy church individual there from not this area. This was from some other stuffy area. No, just kidding. This person was really complaining about helping the poor and just giving handouts. And this was an elder in a church, and he was kind of passionate about this issue. He said, "I don't think we should really help the poor unless, you know, we're bringing them to church," which was, you know, he was trying to make a valid point there. But he said, "In fact, sometimes they'll sit outside our door and they'll wait for a handout, and we're hesitant to give them things. And we've often said, hey, we have dinner, lunch inside. The doors are open. Please come inside and join us for a meal." And he said, "But they never come in. So they clearly don't want Jesus. They just want the handout." And Steve was pretty quiet the whole time. Then he just looked at him and he said, "Have you ever brought the meal out to them?" And that was the end of the discussion. The gentleman talked no more. And it was one of my best lines from Steve. So thank you for that. And, you know, you didn't even say it in a mean-spirited way. I think everybody said, yeah, that's exactly what we should be doing. So. The second thing I just wanted to say is a few months ago we had a discussion at my family, and I'm not one that's been around 20 years in a job, as most of you guys know, Marley. We've moved around our fair share. So we were members at Unity. We've been members at Timberwood Church now in the Brainerd area. I was a member at Raymond Church in the cities we were members. So we've been around for a little while. But the discussion came up around the dinner table. And I asked my family, outside of your immediate family, myself and Heather, who has been the most influential spiritual person in your life? And this is a pretty big question because I have a brother that's a pastor. I have a sister that's a pastor. And many spiritual leaders, many churches we've been involved in. But there was zero hesitation. Mike went right away and said, "Pastor Steve." Maddie, "Pastor Steve." Heather, "Pastor Steve." Myself, "Pastor Steve." Says a lot. So thank you. We love you. You're like family to us. Aaron and Allie, you are our second kids. So we thank you for being there with us, and we love you all very much. Thank you.
I want to thank you, Pastor Steve, for everything you've done for me. Thank you for your preaching. Thank you for your service. Thank you that you came to see me every time I had surgery, which was a lot. And you have helped me much in that respect. Thank you for everything. We're listening to my problems and praying with me going to the doctor with me when there was something serious. You've always been there. Thank you.
I have a lot of memories, but when we first started in the church, Ange entrusted Chad and I to take care of her children when they were gone. And that was an honor. And I have many stories about that, but I'll hold off. But it was amazing to see and watch you guys grow, and fun to be a part of your family. And thank you, Steve, for being a part of our celebrations and our sadnesses. And I just have to say, Zach, I hope when you get married that you will not set your alarm for 4:30, 5 o'clock in the morning to get up to get the newspaper and read it and wake up the rest of the house.
So I was in high school when these guys came to Unity. I did not go to Unity, but we did night vision, and Steve was very involved at the school and with different things with schools and mission trips and all that, so I got to know him pretty well. And I remember as a high schooler thinking, they have so many kids and they just keep having them. Why would anyone do that? So if you don't know me, we have six now. So at our wedding, Steve did not marry us, but he did lead worship, and they both came. And Ange was very pregnant at our wedding. I don't remember which baby, but I was, you know, you do the math, we can probably figure it out. But I remember them slow dancing at our wedding, and Ange was so pregnant that they couldn't stand face to face, because seriously, her belly was like here. So he stood behind her with his arms around her stomach and slow danced, and it was the sweetest thing. So I remember just watching them raise that large group of children, and that's been a blessing to us as we have become adults and had our own kids, watching a big family being raised, and watching the parents still continue to be in ministry and serve and give the way they do has been a huge blessing to our family. So I'd like to say thank you for that. And my daughter would like to say something, too.
Thank you for your laughter and your hospitality.
So I'd like to say thank you to Ange for being a great prayer partner for Ruth Anna. It has been such a blessing and encouragement for us. One thing that Ruth Anna really remembers is on her birthday, you taking her out for a huge blizzard. And then going out to the Christmas lights.
There's been a lot of stuff that has happened with me and my family over the years, and I can remember one of the only people who has always accepted us, or one of the first few people who have accepted me and my family and everything, is Steve and his family. Always treating us like another addition to their family. Always opening their arms to us and everything. I remember my dad stayed late at work one day, and he came home with a bucket of, I went downstairs, came upstairs, and there's a bucket of fried chicken sitting on the table. Turns out Steve brought in his lawnmower, and my dad fixed it for free at like 2 or 3 when we got it at 12. Steve showed up 20 minutes later after begging my dad to let him pay him for the work. My dad saying no. 20 minutes later, Steve shows up with a bucket of chicken saying, this is for you. I'm going to take this piece and you can have the rest. Have fun. I just remember that. And then every time there'd be a meal over at the church, hearing Steve saying, here, there's enough for you guys. Come have some. Plenty of food, plenty of greatness. Even if we already had a meal at home, you say, no, there's still food for you guys. We have room. Come on, have fun. So, Steve, thank you guys for everything you've done for my dad, for me, for my siblings. I know my dad appreciates everything you've done. I do, and they do. And I'll always treat you as part of my family, just like you have for me.
I guess one of my favorite memories with Steve is when we played golf over in Raymond on a Thursday evening on a scramble. We get up on number 16, and Steve hits a beautiful drive right down the middle of the fairway, lays it out there nice. We get up to the creek where you got to shoot across the creek again. Now, Steve gets up there, and he's about 20 feet from the creek, bloop, right in the creek. I should go back. When he hit that nice drive, he says, "Oh, I got somebody special riding with me." And then when he hit that one in the creek, and I says, "What happened to that guy, that special guy that's riding with me?" "Well, he kind of got out of the golf cart and left me," he said.
Abby, it's cool that, you know, you didn't have no pictures of me and your dad. You probably don't know this, but besides your mom, he's slept with me the most. So it's cool. You know this now. Didn't want to break this in front of everyone, but it is what it is. Many states, many hotel rooms, many airplanes. We have been on together. Thank you, Steve, for laughing at me as I'm scared to death to fly and get on planes. And gay waitresses hit on me, and the fact that you laughed to comfort me, I appreciate that. I don't know, waitresses, what are they, the flight attendants? Stewardess, yes. Thank you for helping bring laughter in that. It was great. I do want to say, though, that there's a lot more, Ange. It's, I do want to say, though, out of the 20 years you have been here, 9 years of that you have poured into my life, and I'm so grateful for it. When I looked a lot different than I do now, when my clothes were probably 3X. I don't wear a 3X. I know, it's hard to tell. Pants about 4 sizes bigger, and even though I got the cold shoulder from many, you seem to have saw something in me that a lot of other people didn't, and you became my mentor 9 years ago and became my best friend sometime after that, and I'm grateful for the opportunity, the love that you have given me. I'm grateful that you let us fight often, even today, and we could still come out of that hugging each other and just knowing that we're both blessings. And I know you put a lot of time into me, and I can't imagine the time you have put into your church and the people here. I thank you for trusting me with all the bad people you have in your church and the bad things your family does, because now I come and I know who to avoid. And I know all the bad things you said about Abby are true now. So I thank you. But bless you, brother. And thank you for letting me have your husband time and time again to travel with and to go out and do stuff with. That's right, Abby. You best believe it.
Give me that microphone. Who let him have it?
I just wanted to thank Steve for being at the hospital when somebody broke his leg. And I saw you walk in. I was like, oh, thank goodness, something's going to happen. And I want to thank Angie for the gems night that we were trying to do a blackout, and you helped us because we needed a former gems. That was great. And I want to thank your kids because they've always been really nice to me, and I've always looked up to them. So thanks.
Speaking of hospitals, 14 years ago when my first husband passed away, Steve and Ange came to be with us because our pastor in Emden, Pastor Jeff, was not around at that time. And so Steve and Ange stepped up, came to the hospital, and brought us peace, brought us words of comfort, and just their presence of being there with our family at that difficult time was incredible to have him just be there. And also when Braden went, when he was in kindergarten, he had meningitis, and we got moved by ambulance, and Pastor Steve came down without a question or a doubt, just came down and prayed over him so that we could go to the cities to get him more testing and all that kind of stuff. And just being able to be out there in the public, not just for your church, but just for the community and everything that you do for all of us. And now being able to work with you and seeing all the behind the scenes stuff, and it's just an incredible blessing, and to know what you do for this congregation, this community, and everything, and I appreciate what you do.
I know. Sorry. So I've been here about a year, and it's been such a blessing to get to know Steve, and especially Skylar. I just like to embarrass him. It's fun. But it's so amazing to kind of, I remember someone saying in the video, he's always happy. I'm like, I see him in the office. And but he has such a heart for this church, for you all. And it's inspiring to me to see him pour out his heart and soul for you guys. And it's inspiring to me to be able to do that with students and with parents and with our leaders. And I look up to him. And we have times where we get to chat and have fun and talk about how crazy some people are. Not in this church, but like at Bunday and stuff. I hope that went live. Oh, I'm sorry for the Bunday people here. I didn't mean it, I promise. No, but in all reality, you know, I look up to Steve. I've only known him for a year, but I can see the 20 years before that of his love and his heart for this congregation. It's inspiring to me, and I'm so grateful for you two and the way you've raised your kids and making that your first ministry and loving everyone here. So thank you for that.
All right, so my family and I have been going here for a while now, since I was in second grade. And the funny part is that I convinced my family to start coming here because I wanted to go to church with more of my friends, which was Abby. But the truth was that I liked TJ, so, and he went here. But, you know, through the time that we've been here, Steve has been able to pour into me. You know, I spent a lot of time at their house growing up, and just inspiring me throughout my childhood and as I became an adult. And then eventually him marrying TJ and I, that was a huge blessing, and we appreciate that. And then fast forward, as we moved back, we moved to a house here on Sunrise Lane, and all of a sudden there's a knock at the door, and Allie is at the door, and she goes, "Hi, my mom made some bars and thought you might like some." I was like, "All right, thanks." And then a couple months later, we move again, and Ange is at the door, and there's some puppy chow and a bag, and just, you know, just welcoming us into the community. And that just spoke volumes to us of what you guys stand for and the impact you have. And moving forward, I think we're just going to keep moving. So.
April and I actually met Steve and Ange a little more than 20 years ago. He was at a wedding of one of my friends, and it was his nephew in Maple Grove. And he looked at me, "Where is Princeburg?" But we got to know him then, and I thought he was a really cool guy. He had the wedding ceremony was one of the shortest I think I ever attended, which we kind of keep track, and he's got a pretty good track record of a consistent time, but I've sat through many of your weddings over the years. I will speak for my wife, who worked with him for almost 15 years.
You All right. I did not want to do this, but I got the privilege of working side by side with him for 15 years. We've been going to church here for about 18. What a privilege, you guys. You don't understand the love he has for you guys. And I got to see some of that behind the scenes. And the love his whole family, they mean the world to us, and they mean the world to a lot of people outside of this church. And I'm just privileged to be able to have gotten to know Steve as close as I got to, because he helped create who I am today. So thank you.
And they were always, he was always her boss, but I think in the end they're more like siblings, and the bickering and stuff is as well. It fits in there. So, and I don't know who wins those usually. But.
I'd like to thank the congregation here for all the love that you've shown Angela and Steve. And also thank you for loving one and I and Steve's parents when we come. You always give us a hug. You always say hi. And we've had meals with many of you. And we just, at home, when you say we're coming here for the 20th anniversary of Angela and Steve being here at the church, they say, wow, 20 years? That's very unusual. And I said, yeah, but you don't know the congregation. They're great. And thank you for loving all of us.
Hey. Thank you for that. I just wanted to mention that Pastor Steve's parents were not able to be here. Your dad's in the hospital, is that correct? He's out. But there was a medical situation, so we are. It's too bad that they cannot be here, but we're thinking of it.
All right. I just want to say thank you to your whole family, and just thank you for everything that you've done in my life. And blessing me with Allie and Abby, because they've been my best friends, even though Abby's like older than me. And I just really appreciate it. And thank you for putting up with me. And I'm sure I was extremely loud when we were at sleepovers. And thank you for making us breakfast in the morning. Love you guys.
Thank you for being our family. We love you guys so much, and you know that, and I hope you know that. Quick, cute little Ange story. We came upon having a graduation together. And if you know Angie and you know me, we couldn't be further apart on how we plan things. So anyway, they invited us over, and it was really nice, and we were going to plan. And so I thought I was really impressive that I brought a little notebook and a pen, because, you know, I was prepared. And then she flips out this bifold spreadsheet of everything that she's already done and everything. And it was amazing. And I just... thank you for being like that. And God has wired you, Angie, to be like that and raise your children in that manner. They honor you. They're honoring God through their lives. Guys, we love you. Thank you, Steve and Angie. Thank you, kids.
Well, thank everyone for sharing. Among other things, as an aside, we've got some people who are pretty good with the mic here. And we will have anyone taking notes. We have to remember who these people are, because we've got some really witty, articulate people in this body, and thank you for sharing. In addition to saying thanks, we'd like to give gifts. We've got a couple of things, so you bring them forward. By the way, if you want to thank anybody for this event and what's happening today, thank Mary Sue. We had a committee, but I think she could have done it alone, because she thinks of everything. Well, you could just hand it to them. Here is a basketball. I would like. Okay, so we have a basket full of goodies here, and it's quite an assortment. There's a few gift cards in there and a little bit of everything, so enjoy. We are also giving Pastor Steve a Bible. And it's heavy. He picked it out himself, but I noticed from its weight that it must have big print because the pages are really thin. That's a good thing. That's a good thing. Pastor Steve would, by the way, on the back table, we have a journal, and Pastor Steve would love it if you would write a note in there. The planning team has this journal out there, and we'd like you to put some reminiscences or say thank you in some way. Also, if you are interested, you could, in this Bible, neatly underline your favorite verse and put your initials or your name behind it if there is room. We do ask that you take care of this Bible because the pages are very, very thin and we don't want you to ruin it, so we have a special pens back there to write with, and try not to tear any of the pages before he gets to read it. But Pastor Steve, we love you. There you go. We also have another little gift, and we've been passing the hat around, and we're able to gather a little money, and we'd like to send you guys on a vacation. Okay, and we'd like you to decide what that vacation is, and you can decide whether or not it's just you and Ange, or whether you send postcards home. It is as yet undefined, but you look at the check. You decide, okay? I'd like to invite the council to come up here for a second. We'd like to surround the Zwart family for a moment of prayer. Brian has agreed to lead a prayer, and if all the elders and deacons could come up, and if you guys could just come on up here for a moment.
Yeah, okay. Well, 20 years. Goes by fast, yeah. I was thinking there's a lot of notes in the last 20 years, and a lot of prayers and this and that. God's been good. We're thankful. Hey, you've been sitting quite a while. Why don't you stand also? I'd like you to maybe just reach out your hand, if you're so inclined, just bless Pastor Steve and the family, and ask for the Holy Spirit's covering and continuing blessing on this family. Lord, we just, in this season, we want to say thank you. Just thank you for what you've done and what you've given and how you have blessed us. I just think of the message we heard this morning about grace. And we think, Lord, specifically because of grace, things that we do and say that maybe are not right are forgiven. But the things that we do that are good, that bless you and bless others, are multiplied forever. And we pray that in Jesus' name this morning, that what's been done in this place, what's been said, what's been spoken, what's been encouraged, and the counseling that goes on, and the love, I pray you would multiply it forever, Lord, for your kingdom, for your glory. And now we pray, Lord, your continued protection and your blessing upon Steve and his family. We pray the enemy away in Jesus' name. We pray for health and wholeness and your continued covering and favor on this family. Bless them in Jesus' name. Amen.
You may have a seat. And this may be a mistake, but I'm going to give the mic over to Pastor Steve for just a moment.
Just a moment. First of all, a shout out to Ben for two reasons. One is just to see what God has done in your life and empowered you to bring the word. Tremendous blessing. So thank you for being here this morning. The second thing being that you said just about everything I was going to say. So thank you for that as well. When you use the word anniversary, just a funny story. Someone had slipped this event to the local newspaper, so a guy came over, wanted to talk to me about this, and he comes into my office a week ago or so, and so the first question he asked me was, so when is your last day? I thought, what press release did you get? Do you know something I don't know? And then he said, no, when are you retiring? I looked at him like, oh, I don't know. Not anytime soon. I said, this is an anniversary. Oh, I didn't realize that. I said, yeah, don't print that I'm done, okay? I don't plan to be done. On an anniversary, you think of where you've come from. Watching the pictures and hearing the stories, just floods and floods and floods of memories. I didn't realize I took that many naps. It doesn't feel like it at times. But it's also that verse that Ben quoted in Philippians 1 that talks about we're not done yet. The fact that the good work that's begun is still in progress. And I've tried as best I can in all my ministry to approach each of you with that mindset. God's not done yet. Some of you have mentioned that you've appreciated that. Some of you are glad that that was the word you received. But know that my heart still beats with that gospel of grace that looks at each one of us and says, God's not done yet. And in some cases, the best is yet to come, they say. And that's my heart. 20 years ago, when we came here, we came out of some chaos in our own lives. In a very short period of time, we had lost our son. We had moved several times. I launched into full-time ministry with a bang, closing the first church I ever started ministering at. And then some doors closing right after that. So when the call came to interview here, we didn't know exactly where the world Prinsburg was, and drove out here. And we had been living in metros for a while, and so we were like, wow, this is really rural. And came out here. We enjoyed the interview very much, and we said, you know, this is a diamond in the rough. This is a place that God's got stuff to do here. He wants to do. And people need to know about that. We told tons and tons of people about this place and continue to do so. I can remember filling out the call letter, signing the acceptance letter, and we went to a state volleyball game. CMCS was at state volleyball, and we were there at the game, and I had to find this guy named Gar. And I thought, who goes by the name Gar? I remember growing up, that's what we caught out of the sand pits. You know, it's this long, ugly fish with a big beak on it, you know, that kind of thing. And I thought, who is Gar? But we found him. And I can still remember that moment. We're sitting up in the balcony area of that gym. And I handed him that. And just there was something in me that clicked that says, this is going to be incredible. What's going to happen next? And it has been. These 20 years have just been amazing. To laugh with you, to cry with you, to walk through pain together, to enjoy weddings, splash your children, and even to stand here and weep with you as loved ones parted ways from here on earth. God's not done yet here at Unity. And it's my privilege to continue to be your pastor. Thank you for affording me a lot of grace. Thank you for affording our family and blessing our family in so many ways. We are grateful. We are thankful this morning. And I am incredibly thankful to make it through this speech without getting my handkerchief out. So, but thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you for loving us. And it's my privilege to continue to do this as the Lord calls us to do so. So, thank you.
Now it's nearly time to eat. And first of all, we're going to dismiss the high school students. They're going to be the first through the line. And that's not always the case, but we have ulterior motives. We'd like them to help a little bit with cleanup. So we would like them to eat first. So if you are a high school student, head on out. And also, if you have any kind of a mobility issue, you can decide on that yourself. But you're free to follow the high school students. While they file out, I just wanted to say a couple words of thanks. Thanks again for the wonderful praise team this morning. That was great, especially the three Zwarts that were in it. That was great. Thank you for Krista and for the praise team. Thanks to Ben. Thanks to Ben for opening the word. Appreciate that. Great job. Let's see, the dinner today is being served by Max's Grill from Olivia. Max's Grill, and it's Corey and Tracy, so we're going to thank them. I don't know if they can hear us, but thank them in advance. It smells great back there, and make sure you say a word of thanks to them. We have Dan and Liz Marcus and Dalen and Verla Falkert who have agreed to come over and help serve today so that we can all sit and be served. But there's going to be a line. You're going to be going through lines. I think it'll go quickly. And I think that's all we have to say. We will dismiss then by groups. And let's start with the Zwarts and then this section. Go for it. Did we forget anything, Mary Sue? Say that again.